Good evening and welcome to MTV's news update for today, March 20, 2024. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, our top headlines. GTU's vice president admits that salary talks were discussed with government. Guyana did exceedingly well in defending itself at the UN forum, says Attorney General. Two arrested after robbing Zealot Superbet outlet and patrons. And in sport, Milo School football tournament kicks off on Saturday. Now for the news in detail. Vice President of the Guyana Teachers Union, Julian Cambridge, on Wednesday admitted that financial matters were discussed with the government. Cambridge, who made this revelation while under cross-examination, agreed with Attorney Darshan Ramdani. On Wednesday, High Court Judge Sandal Kassoun heard oral arguments in relation to the case filed by the union. The union had approached the High Court seeking to stop the government from cutting the salaries of striking teachers and halting union dues. Justice Kassoun has already granted two conservatory orders until the hearing and determination of the case. We tell you now that Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs, Anil Nandalal, Senior Counsel, has said that Guyana did well in defending its human rights record at the United Nations Human Rights Council. The AG's comment follows media reports about alleged corruption involving Vice President Dr. Bart Jagdeo. This report has more details.
The United Nations Human Rights Committee, UNHRC, has given the government a positive review despite a query from a single member which was reported in the media about alleged corruption against Vice President Dr. Bart Jagdeo. Speaking on his weekly program Issues in the News, Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs Anil Nandalal, Senior Counsel, noted that it was a utter ignorance.
From the moment an opportunity presents itself to put him in a bad light, you have this outpouring from certain segments of the media. Guyana did exceedingly well, I am told, in defending itself at this forum.
The allegations, which surfaced following a United States-based Vice News report, sought to connect Dr. Jagdeo with a bribery scandal involving a Chinese businessman. However, Minister of Parliamentary Affairs and Governance, Gil Teixeira, made it clear to the committee that the claim did not warrant an investigation as no formal complaint was made.
However, because it involves Vice President Jagdeo, who is the General Secretary of the People's Progressive Party, it becomes premium news and prime news to the exclusion of everything else.
To this end, the AG reminded that opposition leader Aubrey Norton is the person driving this alleged corruption against Dr. Jagdeo. The United Nations Commission on Human Rights 140th session will conclude today in Geneva, Switzerland. Minister Teixeira represented Guyana virtually. She has since reaffirmed Guyana's commitment to upholding equality and democracy.
Four residents of D Fields of Hire have benefited from the Ministry of Housing and Water's Core Home Initiatives. We have details in this report.
For years, Jenna Barker lived in Sofia under harsh conditions and her monthly income was not enough to offset the cost of the necessary home renovations. Now, she is proud to showcase her new home built under the Adequate Housing and Urban Accessibility Program. Barker's new house was built on her land at Section D, Sofia.
I feel very happy for finally having my own home. And I also would like to thank the government of Guyana, the Ministry of Housing especially, who tried their utmost best to help me out when I was in a very bad position.
Barker is one of the four persons to receive houses on Tuesday and has been among a large number of Core Home recipients since 2020.
I feel comfortable in the area and I'm happy in my new home. I used to live at the back of the house, right? But it was swampy, and the house began to lean and twist, and I went into housing and get this opportunity.
These homeowners were also presented with their electrical and termite treatment certificates. Minister within the Ministry of Housing and Water, Susan Rodrigues, noted that the program has been positively impacting the lives of citizens.
The Adequate Housing and Urban Accessibility Program aims to help the most vulnerable Guyanese. It's a project total of about 5.8 billion Guyana dollars, and over the last few years, we've been ensuring that we construct core homes across three areas, East Bank, East Coast, and which includes Sophia, and over in Region 3.
More news coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. With our wall and ceiling gypsum system, it's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Cherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sevon's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Looking for fresh, tender, and flavorful meat? Then check out Rossignol Butchery for steaks, burgers, sausages, minced meat, fish, and chicken. For a tasty, attractive cocktail, we have a wide variety of packaged deli meats and cheeses to decorate your platter. We also stock a wide assortment of canned goods, seasoning salts, sauces, and marinade, all in a highly hygienic, welcoming atmosphere with warm and welcoming staff to cater to all your needs. Rossignol Butchery, we meet your needs. 73 to 74 Church Street, Georgetown. Telephone number 223-00.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
FiberTech materials are used in a multitude of ways, from repairing and fabrication of auto body, fishing, and household items. We have available various fiberglass mattings, resin, mold releases, brushes, and rollers for all of your repair needs. We offer technical advice and free training to ensure you get the job done. For further information, call us at 220-6907 or 220-9192.
This is MTV's News Update. Welcome back. In a frowning reminder to judges in Guyana, Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs, Anil Nandalal, Senior Counsel, cautioned that delays in delivering written decisions could lead to their removal from the bench. This comes in light of reports from Barbados where formal complaints have been lodged against certain judges for prolonged delays in issuing rulings. Details in this report.
Judges' delivery of written decisions has been an issue in Guyana, and Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs Anil Nandalal, Senior Counsel, during his weekly televised program Issues in the News, expressed his displeasure with this occurrence. He reminded judges that they could be removed from the bench if this breach continues.
Guyanese from all walks of life are complaining and have complained, and many of you are listening to the program, against the sloth at which the legal and judicial system work.
While this issue is not new, it came to the fore following reports in Barbados that formal complaints have been lodged against certain judges over their delay in delivering decisions.
Guyana, like Barbados, Barbados has it in its constitution, but we have a legislation that mandates judges to write decisions after hearing submissions and arguments in a case within a prescribed time.
Chancellor of the Judiciary Acting Unit Cummings Edwards had said that the issue was not intentional while acknowledging the shortage of judges and judicial officers. The deadline for issuing written decisions is 4 to 6 months after the oral judgment is pronounced. This legal provision is part of a series of measures aimed at expediting the administration of justice.
To improve life conditions for residents of Ingratitude Settlement in Region 3 and fulfill his commitment to residents, Minister of Housing and Water Colin Kroll distributed water tanks to 12 families. Details in this report.
Ingratitude is a small settlement on the west bank of Demerara, Region 3. Living there can sometimes be harsh with the limited access to and storage of portable water. However, Sis Narayan Kanhai is one of the 12 residents who are testifying to a change in the dynamics following the distribution of water tanks in the settlement. Children and pensioners now have more access to clean water.
I'll take this opportunity to thank the Minister of Housing and Water, the Honorable Colin Kroll, for his prompt response towards reaching out to the call of the residents of this area who are struggling to access potable water for the last 6 months.
Each tank can accommodate 450 gallons of water and ease the burden of access and storage. The distribution is the fulfillment of a commitment made by Minister of Housing and Water Colin Kroll. Soon, the 52 families there will receive water from GWI.
Coming up in tonight's court roundup, trio remanded for murder of Region 7 Chinese shop owner and more. Stay with us.
At the Gift Center, we're more than great gifts. Find a fine selection of beautifully crafted crystal pieces or perfect barware for your socials. Get wall art and decor that's guaranteed to transform your favorite spaces. Entertain in style with elegant dinnerware and serving sets. Ladies, accessorize your attire with fashionable yet functional handbags. With our commitment to quality, we are the preferred place to shop. The Gift Center, located at 46 Hatfield Street, opposite the White Castle Fish Shop.
Be a part of the trend everyone is talking about. It's the new frameless shower door with towel bar from Beeson Windows and Doors. You can modernize your bathroom look with hinge or sliding frameless shower doors and get free transportation and installation in Georgetown or surrounding areas. At Beeson, you can also get decorative aluminum doors and railing. Just the perfect look to add beauty and safety to your home. So visit Beeson's today at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site and place your order now. Telephone 622-4197 or 623-4197. Built with pride in Guyana by Guyanese.
BM Soap Auto Sales is Guyana's leading auto sales with over 35 years of experience providing reconditioned Japanese, European, and U.S. vehicles to the local Guyanese market. We also supply new vehicles for corporate and individual requests. Visit our showroom at Area A Success Public Road, East Coast, Demerara, or our head office, Lot 9, Kroll Street, Georgetown. BM Soap Auto Sales. It's your turn to drive.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
tuned to MTV's news update. Two suspects are in police custody after allegedly robbing Natasha's superbet located at Zealot New Scheme, East Bank Essequibo on Tuesday night. Reports are that at about 19 hours 35, two men, both of whom had on face masks and one armed with a handgun, went into the superbet outlet and demanded personal articles from the patrons. The suspects robbed the patrons and also collected the superbet's day sales, which amounted to $109,000. After committing the offense, the two men made good their escape in a navy blue Toyota Fielder wagon. Hours later, the suspects were arrested and a number of stolen items were recovered. Here is a look at tonight's court roundup.
Darcy De Costa, Oscar Sano, and Parel De Salve were remanded to prison on Wednesday for the murder of Leson Young, which occurred during the course of a robbery. The men appeared before Magistrate Faith McGusty in the Georgetown Magistrates Court, but were not required to plead to the charge. The charge stated that on March 14, 2024, at Edinburgh Landing, Cayuni River, they murdered Young during the course or furtherance of a robbery. They were remanded to prison. The case was transferred to the Kamakorang Magistrates Court and would be called again on April 24, 2024. On the day in question, police in the area were informed of a robbery at the Chinese supermarket, which is located at Edinburgh Landing. When the police arrived on the scene, the supermarket entrance was locked. Upon venturing to the back, the ranks found an individual attempting to exit the building. The person was arrested. Upon further investigations inside the supermarket, the ranks found Young motionless. His reputed wife was found in another room alive with two small lacerations to her right jaw. In another matter, Vinish Gupta, the 59-year-old Netherlands national, who is wanted by the International Criminal Police Organization, has been charged with conspiracy to traffic drugs internationally and was remanded to prison. Gupta of Lot 93, Duke Street, Kingston, Georgetown, was hauled before Magistrate Faith McGusty in the Georgetown Magistrates Court. The prosecution plans to present the request to proceed from Italy regarding Gupta, who has been on Interpol's red list since 2019 and is wanted for his alleged association with a mafia organization. Premised on this, the Netherlands national was remanded to prison until March 28, 2024. Gupta, who police said is a businessman, was arrested at a popular city spot on Sunday. He is wanted by Interpol for aggravated criminal conspiracy aimed to commit international drug trafficking.
We now take a look at Tips for Healthy Living, brought to you with the compliments of Dabby's Variety Store.
What does Natura High and Low Milk Powder have? It is fortified with the extra goodness of vitamins A, C, D, E, and K. It is high in calcium, protein, and enriched with folic acid, all of which help to strengthen your immune system. What it doesn't have is fat and cholesterol. Natura, high and low. Healthy can taste good. Available at all leading supermarkets and groceries nationwide. Natura High and Low Milk Powder is not for infants 1 year and under.
A nut is a seed contained in a hard shell which doesn't naturally open to release the seed when it matures. A nut can also be considered a fruit. They are dry, single-seeded fruits that have high oil content and are usually enclosed in a leathery or solid outer layer. Commonly eaten nuts are almond nuts, cashew nuts, hazelnuts, pistachios, walnuts, pecans, and peanuts. Peanuts are actually legumes. They are classified as nuts due to their similar characteristics to other tree nuts. All nuts have very similar macronutrient profiles, such as protein, carbohydrates, and fat. But different types of nuts may have slightly different micronutrient content, such as vitamins and minerals. Nuts have about 29 kilojoules of energy per gram and are high in good fats, such as monosaturated and polyunsaturated fats, low in saturated fats, good sources of dietary protein, which is a good alternative to animal protein. Some nuts are also high in amino acids, which keep blood vessels healthy and improves blood flow, preventing the formation of blood clots. High in fiber, rich in vitamins and minerals such as vitamins E, B6, calcium, potassium, niacin, and folate. One of the interesting things about nuts, frequent consumption is associated with lower rates of obesity and diabetes. Eating nuts promotes the feeling of being full and improves blood sugar control. The combination of good fats make nuts heart healthy. They help reduce low-density lipoprotein cholesterol, known as bad cholesterol, in the body. Eating healthy nuts and seeds are highly beneficial for those who want to enjoy an abundance of flavors and health benefits. It is important to incorporate different varieties into your diet for all the health benefits of nuts in disease prevention.
What does Natura High and Low Milk Powder have? It is fortified with the extra goodness of vitamins A, C, D, E, and K. It is high in calcium, protein, and enriched with folic acid, all of which help to strengthen your immune system. What it doesn't have is fat and cholesterol. Natura, high and low. Healthy can taste good. Available at all leading supermarkets and groceries nationwide. Natura High and Low Milk Powder is not for infants 1 year and under.
The ISG and MTV's sport update comes up after the break. Stay tuned.
A who argue today? Me brother, let me see now. You never see nothing properly.
What do we got for?
My question, no me fair up tell you about this window.
Long now you're supposed to carry me Beeson for my proper window.
Beeson's windows and doors has the best quality, widest variety, and lowest prices of aluminum and UPVC windows, doors, shop fronts, shower doors and enclosures, rails, showcases, and much more. With every 15 windows, you get 2 bathroom windows free.
Me no know what caused this brainwave, but me just glad for me.
Me say me they had one brainwave before me married you.
What you said, I'm okay?
Nothing, baby.
Oh, me thought so.
Beeson's Windows and Doors, lot 1228 New Eccles Industrial Site, East Bank, Demerara. Call 622-4197 or 623-4197. Made with pride. In Guyana. By Guyanese.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
The Hydromet Service Ministry of Agriculture is reminding owners of wells across the country that it is a legislative requirement to have their wells registered with the service, be it for domestic or commercial use. Getting your well registered is just a few clicks away. Visit the Hydromet website at hydromet.gov.gy and to click on the well registration tab. Fill out the registration form there and then click the send button. It's that simple. Be reminded that before undertaking the establishment of a new well, a license to do so must first be sought from the Hydromet Department as well as the Environmental Protection Agency. The process for so doing is explained on the department's website. Click on the link for well registration and follow the directions. A message from the Hydromet Service, Ministry of Agriculture.
Hi, my name is Randy, Chief Mechanic from RNS Performance. We take great care in preparing our vehicles for off-road trips. That's why we choose Ultra Lubricants for our 4x4s, bikes, and ATVs. Off-road is where we see the ultimate and peak consistent performance of Ultra Lubricants against the rough terrain. I recommend Ultra Lubricants.
Ultra Lubricants, world-class lubricants for tropical conditions. Distributed by Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc.
your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF Seal Jet Machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF Seal Jet Machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Student athletes are urged to use sport as an avenue to build potential careers as they prepare to compete in the 10th annual Milo on the 18th Secondary School Tournament, which kicks off on Saturday, March 23 at both the Ministry of Education and Queen's College grounds.
On Tuesday, the tournament organizers met with coaches and students to share details of the event. Speaking to the media, tournament organizer and co-director of Petro Organization, Troy Mendonca, expressed gratitude for the continued support over the years in ensuring that youth footballers continue to hone their skills.
I just want to reiterate that us, as in students, teachers, the media, my colleagues, our sponsors, and the Ministry of Education, Ministry of Culture, Youth and Sports, the Guyana Football Federation, the Referees Council, we all should take kudos for us being here at 10 time. And a special acknowledgement of the teachers and coaches for the role that they continue to play.
Education Officer Joel Gonzalez, representing the Ministry of Education from the Allied Arts, highlighted the benefits of football within the academic system.
Football in the education system brings different groups together. It promotes team building. So you're not going out there as an individual, but you are going out there to represent your school. Win or lose, we have to know when we win, yes, we will celebrate, but what happens if we don't win? If we don't win, that is where the discipline comes in, because you're going to have to rebuild, you have to go back, see what went wrong, and so the next time around, you can go out there and do your best. Football in the education system also promotes youth development, empowering young people to develop skills and capabilities. And I know that you're not just a part of the game because you like the game, or you have little skills and you can go out there and show off, as some people will say. But you are going out there, one, to be the best that you can, and two, to represent your school.
Gonzalez also urged the students to seize the opportunity given to them in the sport due to its potential to enhance their development in the game.
Making a projection that in another 2 to 3 years, we're going to see some of you on our national team, and you're going to remind us, remember when we had that Milo tournament? That is where it all started.
A total of 25 teams are set to battle it out for the championship trophy and the $300,000 cash prize, which will be used for the school project of their choice. The kickoff is set for March 23 at the Ministry of Education and Queen's College grounds.
Guyana's senior men's football team, Golden Jaguars, will be ready to roar when they take to the field against Cape Verde in the newly created FIFA Series tournament in Saudi Arabia.
Assistant coach of the Guyana senior men's football team, Samuel Cox, said there is no pressure on the squad as they get ready to make some history in the game.
Having coached during that Nations League period and seeing the success that we've had, but you know, we've made it clear to the players that there's no pressure on them. You know, we've given them a style of play, a methodology and a philosophy and the way we want to play going forward. So there's that continuity now. Every time the boys come into the camp, this is what we're doing. This is the structure that we play to. And it is at times risky, the way we want to play and progress the ball. But, you know, as a staff, we've taken that pressure away from the players and almost allowed them to enjoy, trust the process. The result is on us.
Looking at the squad's makeup, the former captain of the Golden Jays said he is impressed by the level of commitment shown by the young members of the unit to grasp the knowledge and skills needed to better their careers.
It's about living in the moment, but we've always been clear on the process, on what we want to do and where we want to go. And if we're being honest with ourselves, we're probably above schedule in terms of what we've achieved over the last 6-7 months, especially getting promoted to League A. Like you say, the young players have been fantastic taking on the information, because it's not easy at times. not only do you have to be technically astute, but you also have to be tactically astute to play the way we want to play now. And those younger players, they've been fantastic. Amidst the senior players as well, who have guided them and pointed them in the right direction.
Having arrived in Saudi Arabia on Monday, the team had a few days to acclimate ahead of their matchup, holding a few training sessions in the build-up. Cox, while pleased with the preparations ahead of their clash, said they will look to use the experience from past tournaments to aid them when they take to the field come match day.
I thought the boys were really good, really intense session. Obviously in prep for Cape Verde in 2 days' time. We don't have a lot of time on the grass, but we gave as much as we could with the time given. We've done an analysis session earlier on in the day, so we try to give the boys as much information as possible. But really, it's just a case of building on what we've done over the last, you know, 6-7 months across the Nations League and building on from the success that we had.
The Golden Jacks kick off their FIFA series campaign at 15 hours.
Tiana Springer, Athalia Hickinson, and Jaheel Cornett were some of the top performers in the CURIFTA versus the REST Track and Field Championship on Sunday at the National Track and Field Center on the west coast of Demerara.
Tiana Springer was one of the top runners cruising to victories in the women's 200 and 400 meter finals. After topping her women 200 meters heat in a time of 24.04 seconds ahead of Nalisha Glenn, she was lined up alongside a strong field including CURIFTA qualifiers at Leah Hickson and Nerissa McPherson, who also topped their respective heats. After taking the first turn well in the final, she made some powerful strides to pull away from the field to win in 23.85 seconds, ahead of Hickson at 23.93 and McPherson at 24.54 as she continued her prep for games. Nalisha Glenn, who is also on the CURIFTA team, was fourth in 24.54 seconds. In the women's 400 final, Springer again had to contend with McPherson, but she destroyed the field in the last 100 meters to win comfortably in 56.54 seconds. McPherson was scored in 57.70 seconds, with Marissa Thomas third in 1 minute, 1.30 seconds. In the women's 100 meters, Hickson came to the fore, winning in 11.51 seconds, with her CURIFTA teammate Nalisha Glenn second in 12.01 seconds. The men's 800 final saw Caden Persaud, the best CURIFTA team finisher, take third place in a time of 1 minute 56.60 seconds, with his teammate Jamal Sullivan fourth in 1 minute 58.96 seconds. GDF Simeon Adams won it in 1 minute 55.02 seconds, with Kosi Thomas second in 1 minute 56.56. Senior Nolex Holder also beat off the challenge of CURIFTA selected Jaheel Cornett in the men's 200 finals with a run of 21.06 seconds. Cornett was scored in 21.70 seconds, with Police Sports Club Shamar Veloza third in 22.13 seconds. Cornett, who will compete in the 200 at the CURIFTA Games, won his heat earlier in that day at 22.15. In the men's 100 meters, Jaheel Cornett finished in third place, piped by the Police Holder and GDF's Akeem Stewart to the line. The bronze finisher looked in good touch to finish in a solid 10.44 seconds, but would not take the 100 meter final win. Holder crossed the line in 10.14 seconds, with Stewart away off in 10.43 seconds, just ahead of Cornett. The other CURIFTA athlete in the race, Skylar Charles, was 7th in 10.96 seconds. The men's 400 meter final saw the dominance of the seniors as Nicholas Daw came out on top in 49.83 seconds, with Quancy Reynolds of GDF second in 50.09 seconds, followed by Police Denielson Gill in 50.40 seconds for third place. CURIFTA athlete Caden Persaud was the best finisher for the youngers in 53.23 seconds for fifth. The country's 23rd member CURIFTA squad returns to action this weekend for their second preparation camp, led by the 2024 CURIFTA coaches Moses Padles and Trishel Thompson, as well as a cadre of local coaches. The CURIFTA Track and Field Championships will be held at the Kieran James Athletic Stadium in Grenada from March 30th to April 1st. The team is set to depart for the games next week.
That brings us to the end of Sport Update, which was brought to you with the kind compliments of ISG. More after the break.
Hi, my name is Randy, Chief Mechanic from RNS Performance. We take great care in preparing our vehicles for off-road trips. That's why we choose Ultra Lubricants for our 4x4s, bikes, and ATVs. Off-road is where we see the ultimate. and peak consistent performance of Ultra Lubricants against the rough terrain. I recommend Ultra Lubricants.
Ultra Lubricants, world-class lubricants for tropical conditions. Distributed by Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana Inc.
And that brings down the curtain in tonight's newscast. But before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. GTU's vice president admits that salary talks were discussed with government. Guyana did exceedingly well in defending itself at the UN forum, says Attorney General. Two arrested after robbing Zealot Superbet outlet and patrons. And in sport, Milo's school football tournament kicks off on Saturday. Catch a rebroadcast tomorrow at 6:30. Don't forget to like our Facebook page where the news can be viewed live at 19:30. On behalf of our news and technical team, I'm Ashley Scotland, saying stay safe and goodbye for now.